Alrighty, so next thing, I'm gonna put all three of these videos together at once. Once I get everything done canned and we put it out on the towel so you can see everything. Now again, this is the one that we're using, the cheddar cheese sauce. And then we can this for different reasons, but our main reason for canning it is we do a duplicate of Arby's beef and cheddar. Oh my gosh, you guys. It is so good. We took that out to Mark actually when he first got home from the hospital. And he absolutely loved it. I should remind my sister how much he liked that so she can make him some. And they were really good. And we've made them, what, once or twice since, Jack, haven't we?
Yeah.
They're really good. So if you hear that steaming over there, that's what that steaming sounds like for the 10 minutes. So that it's ready after that 10 minutes for your cap to go on. So you hear the hard steam. That's what you hear. Jack's in the background cleaning up my mess. I usually always do it, but he's trying to be more organized today and not get on my bad side.
Yeah.
I can be a very impatient person sometimes, and it's not one thing, not something I deny either. Just certain things should go the way they are. So how's you guys' Father's Day going? Pretty good, I hope. My husband, I put him to work. He's out trying to dig up a lilac tree my oldest son planted for me a couple of years ago. But it's gotten so big that we're afraid it's going to get in our tiles out in front because, you know, we live in the city. And we don't need that because that'd be thousands of dollars worth of damage. So he's actually going to pull it up. I have a couple of them in the backyard already. Because we have this really ugly green garage at the back of our property. And I really don't want to see it anymore. So hopefully when those trees get big enough and my rows of Sharon get big enough, I will never ever have to see that ugly green garage again. That's the goal. So that is the ultimate goal there. So he's... This one's taking root, and I told him, I said, I don't want to feel bad for you because I've told him for 2 years now, you really need to move that tree. It's getting big. And he didn't listen, so now he's got a real big mess out there. He's got to cut around the roots and everything else, so. Yeah. Jack helped him a little bit last week, too. Now, honestly, this cheese here, I'm going to use one of my jars. This cheese here we use for a lot of different things, too, because you can, this is the cheese that we actually use to can our mac and cheese as well. So, but we, the only difference with that is we add chicken broth to that. So maybe the guy at our auction service, my customer, he wants the mac and cheese really bad, so maybe I'll make up some more mac and cheese and show you guys how we do that too. But once again, that is not something that the three-letter agencies want you to make. So what do you consider a rebel canning? And I might be a big girl, but I'm still a rebel. I don't like to be told what to do or how to do it. Jack can tell you that one.
That's true.
I don't like that. And so if I can be a rebel with something, I want to be a rebel. All right. So we're going to have 6 pints of those as well. Jack left out. I happen to have an old ring here and an old lid we'll use for that. So we're going to get these done, and once again, make sure all of your lids are your rings. I can't even talk today. Must be Sunday. That'll come off in the water anyway, Jack. But that's another thing. When you guys get done canning, make sure you always, you know, do the lid test where you lift up without the ring on. Make sure it doesn't come off. And then you want to make sure that you wash all your lids. Because even if it didn't sieve or whatever they call that, you want to make sure that you don't have sticky stuff on your shelf, because that could bring ants in, and you don't want ants. So I will, we'll can these after the queso gets done, and then I will bring you back to show you everything that we've canned when we're done, and it'll be all three videos at once. So you guys have a blessed day.
Bye.
And we're back. So now we're going to do queso. So I need to pour one of those cans in here, Jack. While I'm doing that, he's going to wash up my water bather, because we just used it.
I finally broke it.
So this cheese, we get at Sam's. And I'm going to tell you guys, if you want to make this, do it quickly. When we first started making this, it was $6 for the $5.82 or something like that for the 10-pound can. It's now up to $9.82. So if you want to make this, I would do it relatively soon, because the prices are getting astronomical. So this one, the first one we're doing is the queso. The other one I'll can right from the jar. All right, just leave that in there for now. All right, so now the queso, most recipes will only call, you got to wash this thing out real good. We'll only call for one jar, but we've made this a few times now. So we actually use two cans. It makes it a little bit spicier, but not too, and the flavor is even better. So we use two cans of the original Rotel, not the spicy, because neither Jack nor I like a lot of spice. My husband neither, for that matter. All right. So we put two cans of that in there. I'm not even doing nothing but making a mess today. I need that. Sorry for the noise, guys. So we're gonna mix that together really, really good. Drain your liquid, because you don't want it too overly liquidy. But honestly, you guys, and I know I keep saying this, but you know, the queso in the store, usually I think you can only buy it in the mild anyway, but or the medium, which makes it too spicy for me, but I don't know. I don't know if it's just they got a bunch of preservatives in it or what it is. I'm not sure. But this stuff is so much tastier. My daughter-in-law's mom, we ended up sending her, I don't know how many cans of this, because her and her husband got addicted to it. So I think we sent the last time, I think we sent her 6 cans of it, because she totally got addicted to it for nachos, burritos, all kinds of stuff. They got really addicted to this stuff, because it is that good. So this, again, we're going to fill to the 1-inch head space. Now this one, because it has acid from tomatoes in it, and actually I do not really debubble this one. What I do is I do this here. I'll show you. I just snap it down a couple times. If you wanted to bubble it, it's going to be messy. But you can debubble it as well. I'm going to set them over there. Jack's got a mess. I told him he had to be more organized today, didn't I, Jack?
Yeah.
I don't mind helping and doing stuff, but I just get flustered when he's not as quick as I want it to be. I forget how many we get every time we do this, so. Once some fills over the side and I have to lick it off my finger, it really breaks my heart. I'm kidding.
Well, if he needs more, I'll put more in there.
Let me see. That is not going to go over the top, guaranteed.
I'll put more in there.
And then that tray needs to go in there. Now, like I said, with these, they're going to be able to be water bathed. And with this, it gets water bath for 20 minutes. And because it's cold going in, the water is going to be cold. So is the jars. Everything is cold. And then we had a quart of tomato sauce left from the big can making his goulash. So we're actually going to can that as well. And it's 20 minutes for that too. So I am going to cook dinner today. It's just going to be a little bit later. We went and got Jersey Giant subs today. Ugh, I love those. Usually husband says no. But on Father's Day, he actually said yes. I was like, yay. I was so excited. Maybe felt good because I made him breakfast this morning and all that. So maybe I spoiled him. I don't know. Now that one's past the 1 inch, so I'm going to take a little bit out of there. Because you don't want anything that's not going to seal. That's wastes a lot of money, and you don't want to do that. So, but I think we got 7 last time. I think it's hard to remember from time to time what you get in every one of them. But I'm telling you, even if you use this just for chip dip, whatever you use it for, you guys, it is so good. It is so good. Like, I could eat a whole jar of it myself probably if I didn't get some. Yeah, Jack said he can too. It's really, really good. I think my sister actually tried it too. I'm not sure, but I think she did. My poor towels always get so messy. I think it probably will do 7. And if not, I'm sure it'll break Jack's heart that he'll have to eat some with chips. Will that break your heart, Jack?
Oh, no.
He's like, no. Well, that makes 6. So we will see if Jack gets leftovers or if he has to can it. We shall see here. If you don't can a full one, you know, you might as well just eat the leftovers. And
no leftovers.
Nope, I think you got leftovers, Jack. Because that's about all you're gonna get. So this one you don't can. You will just put your lid on it and put it in the refrigerator until you're ready to eat it.
Oh, that one.
So those ones need the lids. Now this one, how this works is, and we'll put that one in with this. How this works is, we're gonna fill up the water bather. The water needs to be 2 inches over, or at least 1 inch, I'm sorry, over top of the top. And you bring it to a boil before you start your counting. Once it comes to a rolling boil, I mean like rolling, then you count your timer, and for this it's 20 minutes. So we're gonna get all those loaded, and then I'm going to show you the cheese that we're making. We'll talk to you in a minute. Hi guys, happy Father's Day. So today, we're gonna do a couple different canning things with Jack. The first one, I've already got it mixed up. We're doing goulash, which is, I have to say, it's not a, it's Rebel Canning. It is not from the lettered agencies anyway. But in my goulash, I have hamburger tomatoes, tomato sauce, mushrooms, onions, tomato, chopped tomatoes, and salt, pepper, chili powder, garlic powder, and crushed red peppers. So I'm going to fill these. You want to take that spoon out of there for now, Jack? I'm going to spoon these into it, and when I tell you to leave about a little bit more than an inch head space, because the noodles will expand just a little bit more, because you don't want them to not seal. You can move that chair up just a little bit closer, Jack.
A little bit closer to you?
Yep. No, this way.
Oh.
And a little bit farther. There you go. We need the debubbler.
Oh.
I think it's in the sink. So he might not be cooking with me for a couple days, because today he's got all that barbecued chicken that he did yesterday, and he might have quite a bit of goulash left. So you might have just me for the next couple days. And then I'm sure he'll catch up.
Yeah, eventually.
So this, actually, remember we had it the other day here at my house. And it was canned. And I'm telling you guys, it tastes just like you just made it off the stove. And actually, last night's spaghetti, I hadn't tried it yet. My husband had ate it. I had not.
I don't see it in here.
And honestly, he put it over there. Honestly, it tasted like I freshly made it. It was so good. And I put all the hamburger in there, I'm not gonna lie. We both like our stuff burgery.
Last night it was pink.
Well, the other one's over there, isn't it?
No, the other one's over here.
The green one. Yeah, you can use that. Now, to debubble this, what we want to do is, on these, we don't want to push it down too far, because you want to keep it up in here, but you want some of your juice and stuff. So basically, with this one, you're just going to lightly bubble. Unless you see, like right there, is a bubble. You want to get that bubble out of there. But you don't want to push it down too hard, because you want room for expansion. Do you know what I'm saying? You don't want it to be too awfully tight. You can put water in your can or two, Jack.
Okay.
I'm going to put just a tad bit more in there, not much. Just to bring it up just a little bit. On any of these things that you do like this, you want to make sure that you stay within your headspace. And I have tested all of these that are non-ABC related, and they're very good. It's just because they haven't tested doesn't mean that people haven't done it for years. And people that want ready-made meals, they want stuff like this. You know, you quick, like I showed you last week, how fast canned foods that we've done at home, how fast they really, truly can make your dinner. And you know, if you're working parents, whether you're mom, dad, or both, you know, I mean, we know how valuable that time is with our kids. You know, when you get home from work, and the last thing you want to do is spend an hour cooking dinner. I always felt like my kids miss so much of me when, you know, especially when I work nights, but, you know, because they had to, you know, deal with mom cooking for an hour. That's fine. You want at least 2 inches of water in your canner. Now, everything going into my jars here is cold. I did not heat up anything. Oh, you know what else I forgot to tell you guys? I put in there onions. So you can start wiping the lids, Jack. We're going to make this just a quick video. Get all those filled, and then we're gonna can queso and cheese. So those two things are yummy, yummy, yummy. Although my son did, I got to see my grandsons today, because you know I'm a new grandma from our second grandson. Monday he'll be 2 weeks old, so I got to hold them both today and love them and do all that good stuff that grandmas get to do. It's so exciting being a grandma, I'm telling you. It's probably one of the best things in the world past being a mom, is being a grandma. It's an incredible thing. So we got to spend some time. That's why we're starting a little bit late today. Because family always has to come first, people. Always and always and always. I'm a big family person. Always have been, probably always will be. My family, whether it's my kids, my sister, my brother, you know, my kids, my grandkids, whoever it is, they come first. And I think that's how it's supposed to be in this world. Well, other than God. God always comes first, sorry. But so if you guys notice, my sister has gotten her confidence up a little bit now that she's had good news about the trach. And she is actually starting to get her channel up and going that she started like 3 years ago, but never did anything with it. And now she's building up her confidence. It's called Nessa's Nook. So if you want to jump over there and look at her, she cooks more with gadgets, but she likes to dehydrate. She likes to freeze dry. She's got the freeze dryer. I don't. She likes to do all that stuff. So you're going to get a different perspective because she's definitely a gadget cooker. I'm not. Her and I are completely different than that. And like when she's watching my video, she goes, "You're right. We really do cook differently." Because we do. And she calls herself a lazy cook, but I think we both are. We don't want to have to do more than we have to do, any more than you guys do. So we're going to get these loaded up. Now, because it does have hamburger in it, and they're in quarts, they have to be processed for 90 minutes. So we're going to put them in the pressure canner, and it has to be pressure canned too. Let it come up to pressure. Let it steam for 10 minutes. Then we'll put the jiggler on and start our counting at 90 minutes. So we will be back. I'll show you what they look like finished. And then when we get everything set up to can the cheese and stuff. We'll see you in a little bit. Alrighty, so there is the goulash. And there is our queso. Mission accomplished, and Jack has his cheese at home finishing up right now. Have a blessed day.